Implementing any CRM can be challenging on many levels, but with proper planning, you can take off the load. It's important that you understand what it takes to implement Zoho CRM and be prepared to lead your team to success. In this video, we'll help you ask the right questions so that you're ready with a plan to set up the Zoho CRM account for your business. The CRM philosophy is pretty clear: putting your customers first. This idea gives way to three other aspects that are important in planning your Zoho CRM implementation. We call it the three P's: priorities, process, and people, and each one has its own significance. Let's take a look at them. Priorities. Before leaping into the actual implementation, make sure that you set your priorities straight by asking yourself the right questions like, what am I trying to achieve using Zoho CRM? What are my key business priorities? As a business, you might have certain expectations from your CRM, and for all you know, you could end up setting up your CRM account differently and expect the right results in the wrong places. To avoid that, make sure you get this first step right by defining your business objectives. The best CRM metrics will depend on the unique goals that you have in mind. This generally differs from one organization to another. Let's take a look at some of the business priorities that your organization could have. Increase customer satisfaction by encouraging customer engagement to keep them happy and thus loyal to your business. Boost your sales and process efficiency by identifying and eliminating loopholes in the sales process. These efforts can lead to an increase in sales conversions. Reduce operational cost and time by effectively automating repeat processes and actions and managing clean CRM data in the cloud. Centralize all customer-related data and avoid functioning in silos. Customers' data is not just the phone numbers and email addresses, but also their email communications, social presence, and the support requests raised by them. Among other goals and priorities, you could have client retention, customer experience tracking, and cross-selling. The next aspect is process. Business processes are designed to streamline the way your business runs and your teams work. Understanding them will further facilitate implementation. Document it. First, chart out the elements in the business processes. Make sure your team has a clear understanding of the processes that will be implemented in the Zoho CRM account. You can have a flow diagram of how you gather your business leads and qualify them, how the leads travel in your sales pipeline to become a customer, follow-up routine for prospects, running marketing campaigns, acquire payment for deal closure. Next, analyze it. Explore each phase in the process, as there may be sub-steps that could be missed out. Consult people who regularly use the process to get a better understanding of the steps involved in it that cause delay in the process, that create a bottleneck, where sales reps or other team members face challenges. Analyzing the business process will greatly help in identifying and fixing the loopholes before you implement it in Zoho CRM. Also, by going over each step of the process, you may find a more efficient or faster way to do them in Zoho CRM. Lastly, map your processes and business requirements to the various features available in Zoho CRM. The visual representation of the process, like flow diagrams, will help you analyze the extent of customizations needed and processes or steps that require automation. As you're working on the process blueprints, identify your business language that matches with Zoho CRM's default terminology. While an e-commerce company may use terms like wholesale products, shopping carts, discount codes, signups, and refund, a real estate company might use brokers, home warranty, listings, holding deposit, and built-up area. So it's important that you map out these native phrases while listing your business flow. Later, while customizing your account, you need not spend time in figuring out what represents what. And finally, don't get carried away. Analyze well, make a list of features that suit your business model and requirement, and use only those features in an efficient manner. Avoid overwhelming your users with a new CRM and new business processes all at once. They might find it difficult to adapt to all these new things. Above all, convince the people in the organization that the new CRM will make their lives better. Now, onto the third and most important aspect of your implementation planning, the people. If a CRM chosen by top management is forced upon the sales teams without their consent, it will definitely lead to a failure. Besides, chances of rejection can be much higher if you don't involve the right people right from the beginning when CRM is implemented in your business model. Zoho CRM can improve and uplift your business, but only if you pull together the right mix of people in a team. And this should be done right from the beginning of the implementation planning. Be ready to hear disagreements, different opinions, and suggestions, as all the people in that team may not readily like a change to a new CRM. But you still need those various personalities and roles for a successful CRM implementation. Let's identify the stakeholders. The leader is the one who steers a team to success and is the key in driving an implementation project. This person is your project manager who knows the benefits of a CRM, has a good knowledge of your CRM processes, and is ready to experiment new methods. Your project manager needs to be a subject matter expert who can greatly contribute to the overall implementation of the business process and CRM requirements. The demanding. This person is one of the strongest motivators during implementation. They're the sales manager who will keep their sales team motivated to get the best out of the CRM. They'll have the details on the exact reports that are needed, the various business flows, and have a pretty good idea of what is not working in the current system and what needs to be fixed in the new CRM. The real user. These are people from all key user groups such as the sales reps and marketers. To get a full return on your CRM investment, your sales reps have to see real value in it. Ensure equal participation from them, as they're the ones that will be using Zoho CRM almost daily and will have substantial feedback and useful insights that can be considered from day one. To get constructive feedback, you could also have online discussions and surveys with focus groups, including sales reps who have been with the company for a long time and those who are fairly new. More importantly, it's better to include them this way rather than throwing them completely into an unfamiliar CRM. The next important person is the administrator, who plays a critical role by bridging the gap between your CRM and the users who use it. With a good understanding of the product, the CRM admins handle diverse requirements for multiple user teams to map their business processes in the CRM. They not only set up the CRM, but also constantly work on ideas to improve CRM usage and make user adoption easier. And lastly, the decision makers are the optimistic group of people who want to see the business grow and are usually the top officials in the company whose team is going to adopt Zoho CRM. They live by example and are ready to see the CRM in action. They'll support you in many ways to move forward and demonstrate great interest in getting the CRM up and running. It will also help to keep your answers to these questions ready before you proceed to setting up the Zoho CRM account. Who all needs access to Zoho CRM in your organization? What specific purpose do they need access for? What data restriction and CRM feature restriction do they need? You don't have to provide CRM access to all of your users. It only puts your data at risk by opening it up to more people than are necessary, but also requires you to purchase more user licenses. Before you move on to the next phase of implementation, make sure you have a checklist of your business priorities and goals, blueprints of your business processes, list of key people who will be involved in implementing Zoho CRM. Additionally, download the ebook, 8 Tips for Successful CRM Implementation, from our resources section for more tips.